Hey, this is Nicholas with the Backyard TARDIS here with some more adventures in locksmithing. Recently, I have had just a number of slew of jobs. That's why you haven't seen videos for a few weeks, but just going to touch on a few of those. I got a call from someone who had taken over a new apartment center, and I've done a couple of these, but this one, they just wanted keys made to all the units. And so they had called me out. And every time I deal with this, I talk to them on the phone. I explain certain things. And they go, oh, yeah, we've got that all in order. And this lady's like, I represent such and such property management, all that. So we're going through. And, like, people haven't received notices. And they're like, well, they're not home. So you're going to have to pick it open and make a key. I'm like, no, if you didn't give a notice, well, I emailed them a notice and I'm like, that doesn't count. You either have to physically have spoken with them or you have to post 48 hour notice on the door. You can't send them a voicemail or an email that does that. Either it has to be posted on the front door or you have to have a physical confirmation from them that you're getting permission on the phone or by text or whatever. And so, okay, we can't go in those, and they're kind of worried about that, and we're knocking on it, and then they knock on one lady's door, and the lady just blew up at her, talking about how she had shown up the other night at 9 o'clock to introduce herself as the new property management, and that she was drunk and she could smell alcohol and everything, you know, this and that. And she's, oh, you know, go on to this and you can specify that you don't want to be contacted after this time period. Do all this. And it just, she's going nuts. She's just going nuts about this and off. And so the lady's talking afterwards and, you know, and she starts saying, you know, hey, you know, we just wanted to notify them as soon as possible about the changes, stuff like that. You know, we didn't think it was that late. It's like, you know, 9 o'clock at night, it's kind of late as a landlord to be talking on a tenant. And, you know, and she's like, oh, we'd had dinner and I'd had a glass of alcohol, but I wasn't drunk. And so she had previously, I had asked some things, and she's like, she had told me that she needed to clear it with her boss and made some phone calls and stuff. And it's at this point when she's trying to defend things, and I'm explaining, like, the way you're doing this is not legal. Like, what kind of property management company are you? And, you know, they kept saying they were this property management company in Sacramento. And they had a website and all this stuff, and her husband were the property management company. Her boss was her husband. They had set up this website, all the stuff, to look official, like a property management company, so that none of these, you know, so that the tenants would think of them as employees and not as the owners of the building. And so they had just bought the building. And they had no idea how a property management company is supposed to be run or what legally they can and can't do. And so it was just a big headache I went into. But once again, it's stuff like this. Keep me busy. I've had a couple more experiences like this with apartment complexes, and maybe I'll talk about those in a future video. But with that said, hope everybody's having a good day, and I'll catch you in the next video.